Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's video we are going to add a sniper scope effect so that we can shoot at these enemies. So if you didn't watch the previous videos, go ahead and check them out. So this video is part of the FPS game tutorial series. Also make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the notifications bell so that you don't miss any one of my next videos. And let's jump right into it. So in this video we are going to add the sniper scope effect to our sniper rifle, but you could add this feature to all of the weapons. As usual, to add a new feature we need to create a script that is responsible for that. So under the scripts folder, let's create a scope script using right click, create C# script, and let's call it scope. Then let's go ahead and attach it to the sniper weapon, and let's go ahead and open it up in Visual Studio. And because we are using the new input system, first of all we need to create a new input action. So let's use input action, but first make sure to use the namespace using UnityEngine.InputSystem. Now let's create the input action variable using input action. So this is the type, and let's call it scope. Then in the start method we need to set it using scope equals new input action. The first parameter is the name, so I'm gonna call it scope as well. Then we need to add the binding, which is the trigger for the action. Normally we use the right mouse button to scope in, so I'm gonna pass in here the string mouse, then slash right button. You could also add the binding for the gamepad. Then let's go ahead and enable the input action using scope dot enable. Make sure to call that so that we can access the input action. And in the update method, we need to check if we have pressed the right mouse button. In that case, we need to play some kind of scope animation. So let's go ahead and check if. Then the name of the input action using scope. Then dot triggered. So this is going to be true when we press the right mouse button. And under this if statement, we need to toggle the scoping. So for example, if we are scoped in, we need to scope out and vice versa. So let's go up here and add a boolean for that using private boolean, and let's call it is scoped, and let's give it the default value false. Then under here we need to reverse the boolean using is scoped equals. Then to reverse the boolean we need to add this exclamation mark, and let's add is scoped. So if is scoped is true, this is going to be false, otherwise it's gonna be true, and so on. And under here we need to play the scoping animation and change the field of view. We're going to check that out, but first of all let's go ahead and create an animation. So let's go back into Unity. Basically we are animating this weapon holder, so I'm gonna create a new animation using this animation window. You can open it up using window animation, then animation. So let's go ahead and create a new clip, and I'm gonna put it under this animation folder. So let's call it scope in, or let's call it scope. Then let's hit save. Then make sure to hit this record button, and let's go ahead and change the X position. I'm gonna change it to -0.15. Then let's move it a little bit to the top by changing the Y position to 0.03. I'm gonna give it the value -0.05. So this is the scoping animation. You can simply create one keyframe, then we are going to use the transition feature of the animator. You will see that later on. So let's go ahead and open up the animator window, and as you can see we have the scope animation. Basically we can scope when we are idle and when we are running. So I'm gonna make a transition from idle to the scope animation, and the same thing from the run to the scope as well. And to control these transitions we need to add a parameter. Basically, I'm gonna create a boolean parameter. Under this parameters tab, let's go ahead and create a new boolean. I'm gonna call it is scoped. Then let's select the condition. So we need to go to the scope animation. When the boolean is scoped is true. And the same thing, we need to transition from run to scope with the same condition, of course, is scoped is true. But also we need to go back. Basically, we need to go back to the idle animation. So let's make a transition from scope to idle, and here let's select the transition is scoped, false this time. Also make sure to remove has exit time, so that we can immediately switch between these animations. Now let's go ahead and test this animator. So I'm gonna put the animator window over here so that we can see the game view. Then let's go ahead and hit play. As you can see, by default the player is idle, and you can see it over here as well. So I'm gonna switch to the sniper. And if we change the boolean is scope to true, you see that we have the scoping animation. And if I give it back to false, we can go back to the idle animation as well. So it's actually working. Now we need to change this boolean from the script. So let's go back to the scope script. First we need to add a reference to the animator. So let's go up here and let's add public animator, and let's call it animator as well. Then down here, let's go ahead and access the boolean that we've just created using animator.setBoolean, and it's called isScoped. Make sure to spell that right. And let's change it to the boolean isScoped, which is this variable. Now let's go ahead and save the script and go back into Unity. And before we hit play, we need to reference the animator component. So let's go ahead and drag in the animator component, and it's under the weapon holder. So let's go ahead and drag in the weapon holder that contains the animator under this animator variable, and let's hit play. As you can see, by default the player is idle, and when I hit the right mouse button, we can scope in, and when I hit it again, we can scope out. So it's actually working. But the scope effect is not just a simple animation, so we need to add the scope overlay and hide the weapon as well. And also we need to change the field of view. So first of all, let's go ahead and add the scope overlay image. So under this canvas, let's go ahead and right click UI, and let's choose an image. I'm gonna call it scope overlay. Then I need to import an image, so I've already downloaded this image. You can download it from the link under the video description. So let's go ahead and import it into Unity. And I'm gonna put it over here. Then let's go ahead and change the type to sprite2D and UI. Then make sure to hit apply. Then let's select the scope overlay object, and let's select the sprite that we've just imported. Then let's go ahead and hit this set native size. Then let's go ahead and change the canvas type from constant pixel size to scale with screen size. Then let's go ahead and change the width and the height. And let's change the match to the height. Also, let's go ahead and change the position of this overlay. So I'm gonna put it over here so that we can see the amount of ammo down here. So by default, we need to disable this scope overlay. And under this script, let's go ahead and add a reference to it so that we can activate it using public game object. And let's call it scope overlay as well. Then down here, we need to check if we are scoped. Then we need to enable it, otherwise we need to disable it. So over here, we can check that using if is scoped. In that case, we need to enable the scope overlay using scope overlay dot set active true. Otherwise, so else, let's go ahead and disable it using scope overlay dot set active false this time. And now if we save the script, and let's go ahead and reference this scope overlay. So under the scope script, go ahead and drag in the scope overlay game object, and let's hit play. And when I hit the right mouse button, we have this scope overlay image. And when I hit the right mouse button again, we are scoped out. So it's working, but we need to hide the weapon. So the easiest way to hide the weapons is to create a weapons layer, then assign it to all of the weapon models. And under this main camera, we have this calling mask property. By default, it's set to everything. And if we want to hide the weapons, we can uncheck the weapons layer from this list. So let's go ahead and create a new layer and assign it to all of the weapons under here. Let's add a new one. I'm gonna call it weapons. It's under the index 11. Then let's go ahead and assign it to the children of this weapon holder by changing the layer from here. And make sure to select this option to change the children layer to weapons. So when I go over here and uncheck the weapons, as you can see, we can't see it. Then we can give it back to make it visible. So we are going to do that using the script. So let's go back to the scope script. And under here, when we are scoped in, we need to change the calling mask. So let's create a reference to the main camera using public camera, and let's call it FPS cam. And under here, we can change the calling mask property using FPS cam dot calling mask equals the old one using FPS cam dot calling mask. So here the notation is a little bit weird. So to make the weapons layer invisible, we can add this AND operator, then the squiggly one, and let's add in these parentheses 1, and then we have this shift operator. And because the weapons layer is at the index 11, let's go ahead and add 11. So this is going to remove the layer at the index 11. Maybe they need to add a new method to remove a specific layer by adding the name of the layer. But if we are scoped out, we need to make it visible again. So I'm gonna copy this and paste it down here. And to make it visible, basically we need to remove this squiggly. And instead of using this AND operator, we use the OR one, which is this character. So let's go ahead and save the script and go back into Unity. Then let's go ahead and reference the camera under this scope script. I'm gonna drag in the main camera and let's hit play. And if I hit the right mouse button, we have this scope overlay image and the weapons is invisible. And when I hit again, it's visible now. But we need to make a little bit of delay. So we need to wait until the animation is finished. Then we can hide the weapons and enable the scope overlay. And to do that, we can use the coroutine. So if you don't know what is a coroutine, make sure to watch the video under this video description. So let's go ahead and create two methods, one that we need to call over here and another one over here. So let's go ahead and create IEnumerator and let's call it onScoped. And under here, before we call all of these lines of code, we need to make a little bit of delay. And to do that, we need to use yield, return, new, wait for seconds. So this is a coroutine function. And in here, we can pass in the delay. Basically, it's 0.25 seconds. That's the transition duration. And then we can call all of these lines of code. And over here, to call this coroutine, we use start coroutine. Then let's pass in the onScoped and make sure to add these parentheses. And under here, when we are scoped out, we don't need to create a coroutine. So I'm going to create a simple separate function, void. Then let's call it onAndScoped. And let's paste the lines of code over here. And we need to call it under this else statement, onAndScoped. Now the problem will be fixed. So let's save. And let's hit display button. And if I hit the right mouse button, we are scoped in. And when I hit it again, we are scoped out. So it's working. So before we finish this video, we have few problems to fix. The first one is about the reloading. So when I'm scoped in and I start shooting, now the weapons is actually reloading. So we need to make sure that we are scoped out when we are reloading. And to do that, let's go back to the scope script. First, let's go ahead and correct the names. So it's called onAndScoped. And make sure to change it over here as well. So to fix the problem, we need to check if we are reloading. In that case, we can call the method or the function onAndScoped. So first of all, we need to access the gun script. Because we have all of the properties that is related to the gun script, like the current ammo and if we are reloading or not. So let's go ahead and access it using gun. This is the type. And let's call it gun. And to get it, we can use find object of type gun. So this is going to return the gun script. And over here, we can check if gun dot is reloading. I think it's private, so we need to make sure to change it to a public variable. Yeah, it's private, so let's change it to public so that we can access it. And over here, we can check if we are reloading using if gun.isReloading or if the current ammo is 0 using gun.currentAmmo equals 0. In that case, we need to scope out. We can call the method onAndScoped. Then let's add an else over here. So otherwise, if everything is okay, we can call all of these lines of code. So we can check if we've pressed the right mouse button, then we can scope in or we scope out as well. So let's go ahead and save the script. But we have one problem. Here we are calling the method onAndScoped, but we are not changing the boolean isScoped to false. So we can paste this under the functions, or we can change it to false over here. So I'm gonna cut this line of code. And when we call the method onScoped, let's go ahead and change the boolean isScoped to true. And down here, we need to change it to false. So let's save the script and go back into Unity. So let's hit the right mouse button. As you can see, we are scoped in. And when I try to shoot, and if the current ammo is zero, the weapon is reloading. And we can shoot again as well. So it's working. So we've done everything, but we didn't add the scope effect. So it's very easy. We can change the field of view of the main camera to a lower number. So by default, it's 60. And if I try to reduce this one, we can scope in. And when we give it back to the default value, we can scope out. So that's what we are going to do. So let's go to the scope script. And under the method onScoped, let's go ahead and change the field of view of the FPS cam using fpscam.fieldofview equals 30. And when we are scoped out, we need to give it the default value, which is 60. So let's paste that over here and change the value to 60 again. And that's pretty much it. So let's save the script and go back into Unity. And there you go. We've successfully added the sniper scope effect. So if I hit the right mouse button, we can scope in. And when I hit it again, we can scope out. And you can see the field of view is changed. You could also add a few other stuff. For example, you could change the speed of the player when we are scoped in. Or you could change the mouse sensitivity as well. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any question or comment, make sure to write it under the comment section down below. Also, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you don't miss any one of my next videos. And I will see you in the next one.